Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm has been out for a little over a year now. It comes with a few visual changes, like a Wayland native taskbar, with plugins like a GPU monitor and a new default background. But there are far more changes that have been made under the hood. One of these changes is the requirement to use a virtual environment to install third-party packages with pip, rather than installing them system-wide. This places packages into a managed space instead of at system level, which lowers the risk of causing conflicts or breaking other software packages or the operating system. Unfortunately, this change, along with a few tweaks to the way the GPIO pins are used, has made my previous tutorial for installing an OLED stats display on a Pi 4 outdated. If you try to follow this tutorial, you'll end up with a number of errors around virtual environments and broken libraries. So today I'm going to run through how to connect and program an OLED stats display on a Raspberry Pi 5 running Pi OS Bookworm. To start out, let's get an OLED stats display connected to our Raspberry Pi. To do this, you'll need a 4-wire female-to-female jumper cable. The colors don't matter, they just help you keep track of which wire goes to which terminal. The OLED display's terminals are labeled at the front, so make sure you take note of them or label the wires before installing it into a case, or you won't be able to see them. The pin arrangement on these displays is most commonly ground, VCC, SCL, and SDA. You can't just copy this arrangement though, as there are versions of this display that have the ground and VCC pin switched around. If you connect power to the display incorrectly, even just a single time, you'll likely damage it and it'll no longer work. Plug your jumper cable into these four pins, and then take note of which colors you've got connected to which pins. Next, we can plug the other ends into our Raspberry Pi's GPIO pins. Make sure that your Pi is off and the power is disconnected before doing this. You don't want to short a connection or plug a lead into an incorrect pin and not have a chance to check the connections before powering it up. There are a few options for the power pins. I usually plug the ground jumper into pin 9 and the VCC jumper into pin 1. You can use any of the pins labeled ground for the ground jumper, and these displays will run on 3.3 volts or 5 volts, so you can use any of these labeled pins for the VCC jumper. Next, we want to connect the SCL and SDA jumpers, which just get plugged into the corresponding GPIO pins. Plug SCL into pin 5 and SDA into pin 3. Don't get mixed up between GPIO numbers and pin numbers. I'm working off the physical pin numbers. Quickly recheck your connections and we can then start programming the display. I'm going to be working on a fresh 64-bit install of Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm, which you can flash to your microSD card or SSD using Raspberry Pi Imager. Plug the microSD card into your Pi's card reader and then plug in your power adapter to boot it up. If this is your first boot, you'll need to go through a few setup steps and you'll then land on the desktop. It's possible to do this installation on a headless Pi too, as we'll only be working in the terminal. I'll be working with my GitHub repository open, as this provides all of the commands we need to get the display set up, so we can just copy them across to the terminal. Open up a new terminal window, or SSH into your headless Pi, and we'll then start by making sure the Pi's up to date by entering the following commands. When the updates are finished installing, reboot the Pi. Once rebooted, open up the terminal again and enter these commands to install two libraries. Now we need to create a virtual environment to continue the setup in. We'll call this stats.env. Once activated, you should see stats.env at the start of your current terminal line. Next, let's install the Adafruit Blinker library. Once complete, confirm yes at the end to reboot your Pi. With the Pi rebooted, let's now check that it's able to see the connected display. Enter this command and you should now see an address table, and more importantly, you should see the characters 3C in this area. If you don't see any characters in the table, then your Pi isn't recognizing the connected display. So first check your display is connected correctly, and then make sure that the I2C interface is actually enabled. If you get a table full of characters, then you've probably made a wiring mistake, as this happens if SDA is shorted to ground. Next, we can install the CircuitPython libraries specific to this display. We start by re-entering the virtual environment and then enter these commands to install the libraries. We can then exit the virtual environment and download the stats display Python script from our GitHub repository. We then need to re-enter the virtual environment to run the script. There are two options of the script to run. The first is a text-based one called stats.py, and the second is one with icons called monitor.py. You'll need to change the file name in the run command depending on which one you'd like to run. The script is now running, and your display should show your IP address and system stats. We can't leave it like this though. If we close the terminal or reboot the Pi, the script will terminate and the display will stop being updated. So we need to follow some additional steps to get the script to run automatically on startup. This is quite easy to do. We just need to copy this file from our GitHub repository to the root directory. Then make it executable, and then use crontab to tell it to run on startup. Open up crontab by entering this command. If this is the first time you're opening up crontab, then you'll be prompted to select an editor. Select one and hit enter. Then add this line to the end of the file. Make sure you change your name to your username if you're not using the default username Pi. You should now have a working OLED stats display that starts up automatically each time your Pi boots up. You can go ahead and install it into your case if you haven't done so already. My favorite case at the moment is my NVMe case. This accommodates a Pi Moroni or Pineboards hat drive NVMe hat, and an ice tower cooler for cooling. Let me know what you're using your OLED stats display for in the comment section below, or if there's anything you'd like to see added to the display script in future. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.